Can we please have a roll call?
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Present.
Commissioner Monzo?
Present.
Commissioner Meeks?
Catching my breath.
Commissioner Purnell?
Present.
Chairperson McKelvey Day?
Present.
And we have Commissioners Barola and Ramos absent.
Staff introductions?
Ira Robles, Administrative Aide.
Lisa Brinton, Community Development Director.
Courtney Grossman, Planning Manager.
Tom Wiles, Senior Planner.
Welcome, everyone, to the Planning Commission meeting of City of Salinas. We will now go into general public comments. Public comments generally limited to 2 minutes per speaker. The chair may further limit the time for public comments depending on the agenda schedule. Are there any comments from the public regarding items not on today's agenda? Seeing that there's none, we'll move on to consent. Approval of minutes from September 18th, 2024 meeting. Are there any questions or comments from the commissioners? Commissioner Gonzalez?
No questions.
Commissioner Monzo?
Questions.
Commissioner Meeks?
No questions.
Commissioner Purnell?
No questions.
And I have no questions. Is there a motion and a second?
I move that we approve the minutes from the previous meeting.
Second.
So a first from Commissioner Meeks and a second from Commissioner Purnell. Can we have a roll call vote?
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner Monzo?
Same.
Commissioner Meeks?
Yes.
Commissioner Purnell?
Aye.
Chairperson McKelvey Day?
Aye. So motion passes. In public hearings, we have ID number 24-578, Planned Unit Development Permit 2024-001, Third Amendment to Planned Unit Development Permit 2014-001 to change the exterior building elevations, add additional exterior colors to the approved colors and materials board, add new exterior signs and increase maximum allowed sign area in connection with a proposal to create multiple tenants within the former two-story 137,366 square foot Sears store on a 2.85 acre project site located at the Northridge Mall Shopping Center at 1100 Northridge Mall in the Commercial Retail CR Zoning District. Tom Wiles, Senior Planner, will present this item.
Thank you very much, Chairperson McKelvey Day, Commissioners. The proposal is PUD 2401, the Third Amendment to PUD 2014-01, located at the Northridge Mall. The proposal is requested by Ethan Conrad Properties, applicant property owner. It's a request for a Third Amendment to PUD. It's to change the exterior building elevations, add additional exterior colors, add new exterior signs, and exceed the maximum allowed sign area. The project is to create multiple tenants within a former Sears store located at the Northridge Mall on a 2.85 acre site, which is currently regulated by PUD 2014-01. The site is located at the Northridge Mall. The general plan designation is retail and zoning commercial retail. There's multiple tenants at the former Sears store. It would partition approximately 117,100 square foot portion of the building to allow for Burlington Coat Factory, O'Reilly Auto Parts, the Gohan Ase Buffet, David Buster's, which also has a pending CUP application for commercial recreation and entertainment, including alcohol, and a future tenant on the second floor. There are currently pending minor modifications for the commercial tenants for the PUD, and they will be incorporated into this PUD amendment. The facility here shows the floor plans. The first floor plan, there would be O'Reilly's would be on this floor here, on the first floor. Burlington would be located here. This is actually north, west, east, and south. O'Reilly's would be here in the southwest corner. Smash and Axe, which was previously approved with a CUP, is not a part of this project. It's commercial recreation use. Gohan Ase Buffet would be located here on the first floor on the southeast corner. The main entrance, primary entrance for the Dave & Buster's would be on the first floor, and this would be the proposed Burlington. And then on the second floor would be the primary operation for Dave & Buster's and for a fifth commercial tenant, which will be for the future use. This shows the building elevations. This is the west side. There's no major changes to the west side. On the eastern portion, there's changes. This is a change in colors and signs. This is for the Gohan, I'll say, buffet. This is the change in colors for Dave & Buster's, which would include two signs, and a change for the Burlington, and primarily the red background in the sign. And then on the south elevation, this will be area for the O'Reilly's Auto Store, Auto Parts Store, excuse me, and for the Gohan Ase Buffet. The background is that the North Ridge Mall consists of 12 individual parcels, approximately 93.74 acres. Surrounding uses are commercial and residential. It was originally approved with a PUD back in 1969. It was superseded by another one in 1978. And PUD 2014-01, which is being amended the 1978 PUD to allow for multi-phase development. And there are two previous PUDs, 2018-01 and PUD 2022-01. Primarily the recent one was to allow for the proposed Raisin Cane's restaurant on the site, which was located here. As I stated, the North Ridge Mall is governed by PUD 2014-01. It requires an amendment because the proposal and the changes to the signs in the exterior are not minor modification or considered an amendment to the PUD as per the zoning code. As part of the agreement or the approval for the PUD amendment, zoning code and findings need to be established for the PUD amendment. It would reconfigure the former two-story Sears store. The store closed back in 2020, and as stated earlier, the first floor would be three new tenants, and also the primary residence for Dave & Buster's, and the second floor would have the Dave & Buster's and the future tenant. There is no proposed increase in the gross floor area of the building. There is currently no reciprocal access with adjacent mall owners. The previous access agreement expired in early 2024, and so currently vehicular access and loading of goods and materials and off-street parking for the project site is currently not permitted. So one of the conditions of approval is that an RAA reciprocal easement agreement will be required prior to final inspection of any of the building permits. The site is also located within Assembly Bill 2997 because it's located next to transit, does not require additional parking. However, they are not proposing to remove any parking, and then they are proposing to replace all missing landscaping that is located within the project site area, as well as some off-site. The signs and exterior colors, said the east and south elevations are proposed for that. The maximum allowed is per the zoning code is 675.48 square feet. They are proposing 811.63 square feet for all the tenants. Staff believes that the proposed increase in sign area is reasonable and necessary to provide identification for the proposed use. It's similar, in fact, it's less of an increase that was approved for the PUD amendment for Raisin Cane's. The additional colors and materials for tenants' entrances and proposed wall signs on the south and east side, they would be consistent with the North Ridge Mall, and staff recommends approval of the proposed changes to colors and materials for the proposed project. In conclusions, staff recommends that the PUD amendment can be found to be exempt from the California Environmental Quality Act pursuant to section 15332 since it's an infill development project on less than 5 acres and has no impact, especially to parking. And therefore, staff recommends that the Planning Commission recommend that the City Council find the project exempt from CEQA and approve PUD 2024-01. Are there any questions of staff at this time?
Do any of the commissioners have questions for Mr. Wiles or other members of city staff? Commissioner Gonzalez?
I was just wondering if these changes have implications for other developments or it's just unique to this one development.
It would pretty much be, I think, unique to this development as far as it would be to help rebuild or to renovate the existing building.
Thank you.
Could I ask for clarification what you might be asking?
I remember there was another project where if we approved it, that meant that other developments could also have larger signs, and but this isn't, doesn't sound like this is one of those situations.
This is an amendment to this specific planned unit development, not to our zoning code or regulations that apply citywide.
Thank you.
Any questions, Commissioner Monzo?
Mr. Ross, can you explain a little bit more about the parking issue? Because it says that they would have to have a reciprocal easement. I didn't quite understand that.
Well, the issue, quite simply, is that currently there is no reciprocal easement agreement. Let me see here. Within there's several parcels. I think it told me. I just say there's several. The Northridge Mall is consistent of many parcels, and all those have to have a reciprocal easement to allow for access and for parking for people to circulate throughout the site. And there was a 40-year agreement expired. So there is currently no expired and currently no what we call an REA on the site. And because of that, vehicular access and loading of goods and parking is not allowed on any other area outside of the property, outside the mm-hmm. subject site. And so the requirement will be for what we call the REA to get to be completed prior to the final inspection.
Okay, so just like to be able to have shared space across. Yeah. Okay, thank you, that's all.
Any questions, Commissioner Meeks?
Yeah, I have a question. It says here the maximum allowed sign area per the Northridge Mall master plan for Dave and Buster's is 104.9 square feet. And they're proposing 258 square feet. Is that resolved between them and the mall, or do we have to make a decision on that?
That would be part of to agree, or the recommendation of agreement to allow for the excess sign area. And that's what they're requesting. So that's
okay. Thank you.
Any questions, Commissioner Purnell?
I had a quick question. There was a slide that had the Dave and Buster's in parentheses pending CUP. Is there something that's going to come before Planning Commission in the future regarding that specific tenant?
Well, right now, the CUP may either be administrative, or it may, if either the determination is it needs to go to the Planning Commission, or if it, let's say, if it is administrative, it goes to a notice of intent to approve and somebody protests, then it would go to Planning Commission, quite possibly City Council.
Okay, and then one of the slides had mentioned redesign of the current Sears facility to accommodate all of these different businesses. Is that cost encumbered by the businesses themselves to redesign the space? I assume it would be to put more than one business, you would have to spend quite a bit architecturally to accommodate that.
Well, I believe that defer to the applicant whose representative is here, I believe it would be done by the applicant.
Thank you.
And then I have a question regarding the signage. Maybe I'm just not seeing how to do the math, but the proposed sign area, because that's what they're asking to increase, it doesn't list the not designated tenant yet. Like, is there an amount
there's
set aside for them?
Actually, there's a future tenant. And they're not proposed,
okay.
But I believe.
Oh, okay. I was just seeing none proposed, and I was just making sure that we're covering.
They're allowed 47.39 square feet, and that was incorporated into 811. So they only get right now 47.39.
Okay, and then so that's interchangeable depending on what they end up with. They have a grand total, but the owner would be deciding. Like, if any of that needs to adjust, is that within their discretion?
Well, you mean to increase from the 811?
As long as they don't increase, right?
Yeah, as long as it stays within the maximum allowed 811, okay. 69, if the amendment is approved.
Okay, thank you. Now we are open for public comment. Are there any comments from the public regarding this item?
I can just answer any questions you guys have. I'm representative of Ethan Connor Properties. I'm the president of construction for them. So if any of you guys have any questions about the development or what we do, I can answer those questions for you.
Well, do any of the commissioners have questions for the applicant representative? Okay, looks like we have no questions. Oh, go ahead.
This just to be sure in my mind that shows the elevation for the Dave and Buster's. So it's not one continuous solid sign, it's one in, one in, one
yeah.
in?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, thank you. That settles much better with me. It's like, we're David Buster's.
No, it's just a color band with one sign on each side.
Thank you.
I think my question too was regarding that redesign, is there significant like structural issues that are gonna have to happen? Because I know it's been vacant for quite some time, so.
Nothing major. I mean, the property is pretty solid. The openings are the what's are gonna be different. Like Burlington doesn't have that opening right now.
Mm-hmm.
Dave & Buster's does have it, so a little bit of modifications. Same thing with O'Reilly's on the backside. It's getting opened up just a little bit more, but nothing major on the building structurally.
Thank you.
Okay, any other questions from the commissioners to either the applicant or staff?
No questions.
Do we have a motion and a second?
I'll move to approve the project and making an exempt from CEQA and approve the PUD 2024-001.
I second.
So with a first from Commissioner Monzo and a second from Commissioner Gonzalez, can we have a roll call vote?
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner Monzo?
Aye.
Commissioner Meeks?
Yes.
Commissioner Purnell?
Aye.
Chairperson McKelvey Day?
Aye. So motion passes. For PUD 2024-001, Plan Unit Development Permit 2024-001, Third Amendment to Plan Unit Development Permit 2014-001 to change the exterior building elevations, add additional exterior colors to the approved colors and materials board, add new exterior signs and increase maximum allowed sign area in connection with a proposal to create multiple tenants within the former two-story, 137,366 square foot Sears store on a 2.85 acre project site located at the Northridge Mall Shopping Center at 1100 Northridge Mall in the Commercial Retail CR Zoning District. The Planning Commission's action on this item is a recommendation to the City Council in support of Plan Unit Development 2024-001. Staff will schedule the matter for the City Council's consideration, at which time a final decision will be made.
Those will be open next week, right?
Okay, and so now we move on to other business. Any general plan steering committee updates?
Yes, commissioners. Given that we are having elections and anticipating some changeover on our city council, we are going to delay the release of the public review draft to allow the time for the new council to be briefed on the general plan update. So we are now anticipating that it will be a spring release, probably March public review, and that we will have some early study sessions in January and February with the City Council to bring them up to speed and receive their input before releasing it to the public for review.
Okay, thank you. Any follow-up reports?
I don't have any.
Future agenda items?
Got one of those. Next meeting, November 6, Abbott Street, 1012, 1016 Abbott. There's a request to construct a convenience store with gas pumps, and a part of that is an alcohol license. So the actual project is being handled administratively through site plan review and a apparently a lot line adjustment of sorts. Yeah, but the conditional use permit for alcohol being off sale will be coming to the Planning Commission. So the commissioner's purview will be on the alcohol portion of that development. And that's it for that meeting.
Okay, thank you. So the next regular scheduled meeting is for November 6th. Who will be able to attend by show of hands? November 6th? Maybe? Okay. And then you can reach out to the other two that are not present and just confirm that we have a quorum. And then, so with that, the meeting is adjourned.